Hello, I'm Matthew from the Power Apps team, and I'm here to demo for you custom help panes and guided tasks for Unified Interface. We recently blogged about this feature back in November. If you're interested in learning more about this feature, definitely check out our blog. And for more details, check out the custom help pane doc article by following the link at the bottom. On the doc article, it will show you all the information I'm about to show you in the video, including how to enable custom help panes for your environment, and how to author your own custom help panes. But without further ado, let's actually check out what it's like to create and author your own custom help panes. To do that, I already have a model-driven app set up that shows a list of components that we on the Power Apps team use to build Power Apps. Now, if I'm a new user to the team and I come to this page, it might not be clear what I'm supposed to do here. So what I've done is enable custom help panes in this environment so that if I click on the help button, a pane appears that shows just the content that I need to get my job done. I have text showing me what a component is along with an image. I have optional sections that can expand and collapse that provide additional help content. I have a video that I could watch to learn more. And I even have a link that shows me where the new button is if I'm not sure where it is on the page. Now, if I want to edit this content or add new content, all I have to do is click on the dot 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 button in the top right. Clicking on this will show an edit button, which after you select will allow you to enter the WYSIWYG mode. In the WYSIWYG mode, you can instantly start typing additional content. Like to refresh the list if it goes stale, select the refresh button. If I had in a more involved set of steps, I could use a bulleted list, a numbered list, and if I wanted to bold or italicize information, those actions are available to me as well. Lastly, there are all the elements that you can use under the Insert tab. We've already seen a few of them. For example, sections, which are these expand and collapse areas, images, videos, and even links. If I want to change out this image, all I have to do is delete it, select the Insert Image button, find myself an image, copy its URL, paste it in, and then give it a title. We'll go ahead and call it component. And you can see after I click on the insert button, it's placed directly where my cursor was. The component that I like the most, however, is the balloon. To use the balloon, simply select the text that you want to treat as a link, select the insert balloon button, and drag this element to where you want the balloon to appear. In my case, I want to use it on the refresh button. I'll go ahead and give it a title, refresh button, and some details. Clicking on the refresh button will refresh the list. After clicking insert, we see we now have a link. And if we save and click on the button, we can see our balloon giving us a title and a brief description. How cool is that? Lastly, if you want to create a new help page on a new page, simply navigate to the page that you want to add a custom help pane. Click on the help pane button, and you'll notice that there is no help pane on this page. So just like before, click on the dot, 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 select edit, and then provide the information that you want to put there. In this case, we're providing a help pane for this component form. So we'll say component form help, and then provide a brief introduction of this form. Provide the required information on how to use this component within Power Apps. And clicking save, we'll create this help page in the background, and now whenever I come to any of the forms and select the help button, I'll be able to get the relevant help. Now that we've seen how to use and edit help panes, let's see how to enable it in your environment. You'll want to enable it under your system settings. To get to system settings, click on the gear icon in the top right, select advanced settings, and if you're an admin, you'll have access to administration. Under administration, you'll finally be able to find system settings. And if you scroll about midway through, you'll be able to find a new section called Enable Custom Help Panes and Guided Tasks. You'll want to make sure that it's checked to yes. Please note that custom help panes and guided tasks cannot be used at the same time with custom help URLs. You'll notice that if you enable custom help for customizable entities, enable custom help panes becomes disabled. That's because they both use the question mark button in the top right. Once you've enabled it, make sure that whoever is authoring custom help panes has the system customizer role. This will enable the edit button within the custom help panel. Lastly, I'd like to show you how to move content that you've written in your dev environment and move them to your test and even production environments. To do that, what you'll want to do is navigate to your list of solutions and either create a new solution or edit an existing one. I already have a solution called Custom Help right here that already has a few pages inside of it. For example, we can see that there's already a component called How to Use Components inside of here. If I want to add additional pages, all I have to do is click on Add Existing, and at the very bottom, there's a new component called Help Page. Selecting Help Page will show all the help pages that are available for me to use. Selecting that and clicking OK will bring it into my solution. From here, it works like all other solutions. I can export and import this solution into any other environment. This is how you can easily move things from dev, test, to prod. And with that, that concludes my demo of custom help pages. If you have any questions, please be sure to check out the documentation that goes in even more detail about the various elements of custom help pages. Over the next few months, we'll be GAing custom help panes and adding additional capabilities like sequential guided tasks.